Because this is the duty of all disciples under the guidance of the spiritual master to decorate Trivigrahara Dhananityanana Singara. Singara means decoration. Among the various paraphernalia of worshipping the Lord, the Singara is very essential. Singara and Tan Mandira Mahadhanadi, and cleansing the temple. The more you cleanse the temple, the more you decorate the deity, more your heart becomes cleansed and you become spiritually decorated. So cleanliness is next to godliness, and after cleansing, taking baths regularly, keeping the temple very neat and clean, and worshipping the deity, dressing, decorating, ornamenting. These are the general process. So if we follow the process regularly, then we gradually become advanced in spiritual consciousness. Material world and spiritual world. Material world means dirty things, and spiritual world means clean. So the living entities, they are called tatasya-shakti. Parasya-shakti vividhaiva sriyate. God has many potencies. They have been divided into three.
He wanted the European American should come here. It is all Bhaktivinoda Thakur's blessing. Hare Krishna. So there is no scarcity of space for keeping all the devotees.
Everyone is situated in rooms.
Without these wall dwellings, there would have been no hope.
Therefore I said, we must complete, and whatever amount required, I shall pay. That I could not have.
You should have Prabhupada. Only by your mercy you have brought us to this Krishna conscious movement.
Yes. I am simply a messenger. Mercy is of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Prabhupada. Before your coming, they predicted that somebody will bring. Maybe that somebody has. But not that was predicted. So anyway, Krishna has given us nice place, stay here. So you producing food grains?
Oh yes.
Sufficient? What about the fruit garden?
Fruit garden, there's many banana trees are producing the bananas, some pomegranates.
You are getting banana. Both unripe and ripe.
Well, now they're all unripe.
No, there is a class.
Right, the kachakola we have getting very small. So we have mostly the ripe
banana. And he's sincerely engaged in the service of the Lord, he gives him intelligence, now do this, do this. Simply we have to become sincere servant, then all dictation will come from within. Krishna is there in everyone's heart. So, work sincerely. and everything will make problem. Who has painted this picture?
Krishna.
Oh. Very nice. Now, make sublime management. That is required now. We are now extended. We must manage very nicely. Of course, management means sincere service, and everything is all right. Still, we have to deal with the material world. We have to become a little cautious.
Everything you plan is perfect.
No, I imagine Krishna makes it perfect. I think it would have been nice if it would have been like this. But Krishna and Ji Prasade Pureshwar was. Long, long ago, when I was publishing Back to God at one seat, I was thinking that what if this seat, if it would have been like illustrated weekly, then it would have been nice. Now they are coming like that.
Now illustrated weekly is nothing compared to Back to
no.
God.
No. Better than yesterday. I thought of getting some help from artist for painting. Picture I will dictate and they will paint picture. Now Krishna has got lots of artists. So depend on Krishna. He can do everything. Because he is Arjuna, devotee, he simply understood. Yes. Whatever he says, correct. The demons and even the gods, they cannot understand. Oh, why Arjuna understood? That he has explained in the 13th chapter. Nashto moho sating labhya tat prasadat mantusur.
Is he never envious?
Huh?
Arjuna said, "My dear Krishna, O infallible one, my illusion is now gone. I have regained my memory by your mercy, and I am now firm and free from doubt and prepared to act according to your instructions."
Yes. He understood that Krishna is divine. So whatever he says, that is my duty to do. Not to judge him on my platform. And that is Krishna's mercy. One who does not take Krishna in the same platform as one he is, but accepts Krishna's version as it is, then he can understand. Otherwise, how one can accept it that a person has expanded many millions of universes like this? Immediately they will take his mythology. Because he is thinking on terms of his capacity, not as Krishna says. Therefore, nobody could understand Krishna. We took the simple method, accept Krishna as he says, that's all. That is an idea. Our philosophy is simple, because we take it, Krishna's words as it is, that's all. And you believe it firmly, yes, this is the truth. To understand Krishna is not difficult. What Krishna says, you accept it. Sarvamayitam ritam manne jat badashi kesala. Whatever you say, I accept it. Not only I accept it blindly, but this very thing was accepted by such great personality as Vyasa, anyone who wants to come. simple thing. Big, big acharyas, they accepted Krishna as he is. Now why shall I not accept? This is parampara system. If others have accepted Krishna as he tells, and they have become big, big acharyas, what objection can be there from my part? What I am?
They have some completely illogical argument, just like those people in...
Unfortunate. Illogical argument means unfortunate. Rascals. Therefore we say plainly, you are all rascals. We have no discrimination. Anyone who does not believe as he is a rascal. You may be happy or sorry, you don't mind. You don't make compliments. At least I do not do. If you have no full faith in Krishna, then you are asking. Whatever you do. The Dr. Patel does not like this, but he does not protest to me. As others say, he protests by me. This is fine. We have no difficulty to understand Krishna and thus make our life successful. But if we unnecessarily glean arguments, impediments to understand Krishna, therefore we are unfortunate. Envious.
Envious.
They say that they become very agitated when we stress so much in Bhagavad Gita.
That means envy. Envy.
They said, why is it so... Those who are envious and mischievous, who are the lowest among men, are cast by me into the ocean of material existence into various demonic species of life.
All of them are going to Russia. Not Russian people are there. There is a mistake. Some of them. Russian people are good.
Leaders.
That I have experienced. Otherwise, how? Otherwise, how that Anatole came to become mine? And there are many like that, mostly like him. It is by artificial suppression that it has been advertised that Russian people are all communists. That's not fair. That's not fair. Simply some rogues and thieves and demons by threat. It is a country of what is called terrorism.
Yeah.
A terror. People have decided to leave this country, but they cannot leave. Mostly Russians, they want to leave the country, and some of them have already done so. Many Russians have fled out. Many Chinese men have fled out. They don't like this place.
Also, the East Europe countries.
Many countries. It is unnatural to deny God. It is unnatural. This is also Krishna's another magic. All such people who had any doubt about Krishna, they have been kept together in that way. Just like the other day, there was a train crash accident. So all these rascals, they are brought together in that way, in a train or two train and this mast. That is just like Krishna did in battle of Kurukshetra. All the rascals that brought into the battlefield and finished.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
May that Lord, who is known as the son of Srimati Shachi Devi, be transcendently situated in the innermost chambers of your heart. Resplendent with the radiance of molten gold, he has appeared in the age of Kali by his causeless mercy to bestow what no incarnation ever offered before, the most sublime and radiant spiritual knowledge of the mellow taste of his service.
Anarpita charing chirata karuna yavati nakalo samarpayatam unnata ujjalarasang sabhakti sriyam hari purata sundaradhuti kadamma sandipitaha sada ridayakandare spuratu ba sachinandana. This is the blessings of Srila Rupa Goswami upon everyone. Sri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Sanga Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Sapadantika. We should pray to Rupa Goswami for his blessings so that we can understand what is the actual position of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a most merciful incarnation to bestow upon us Krishna Prema. Srila Rupa Goswami understood it. Srila Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya understood it, and we should take their viewpoint of view, what they have studied about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Srila Rupa Goswami says, in the beginning, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was appreciated by Srila Rupa Goswami as Mahavadana Avatar. There are many incarnations of Krishna. Keshavadhrita Meena Sarira Jaya Jagadisha Hare. Keshavadhrita Nishinga Rupa Jaya Jagadisha. Many incarnations. But this incarnation, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is anarpita charing chira. The mercy of this incarnation is unlimited. It was never given before. That is Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. He distributed the most confidential part of love of Godhead. Although we are living in this fallen age, Kali Yuga, but he is giving the topmost platform of loving Krishna, anarpita charing chira. Therefore, he is supposed to be the most munificent incarnation. Namo Mahavadana. Krishna Prema Pradayak. He is giving directly Krishna Prema. It is very difficult to understand Krishna and what to speak of his loving affairs. It is very difficult. Manushyanam sahasyeshu kaschid jatati siddhaye jatatamapi siddhyanam kaschid vetti mam tattva. Krishna personally says that it is very difficult to understand him. Actually, it is so. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy is so unlimited that he is helping not only to understand Krishna, but also he is giving directly love of Krishna. And this supermost platform of love, as it was experienced by the gopis. The gopis dealing with Krishna is considered to be the topmost. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he recommended. Ramma kachi dupasana brajabadhu vargavija kalpita. Brajabadhu, the gopis, the dancers of Vrindavan, they worship Krishna in the topmost loving affairs. They did not know anything but Krishna. For Krishna they could sacrifice anything. Their honor, their prestige, everything. Their husband, their sons, family, that is the gopis' standard. Therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's incarnation is accepted by Srila Rupa Goswami in many verses. One of the verses is here, Anath Pita Charini Chira, Karunayavati Nakalo. So we should take shelter of Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is the blessing of Rupa Goswami. He says, Hari Purata Sundara Dhuti Kadamma Sandipita Sada Aridaya Kandare Spuratuva Sachinandana. He is giving his blessing that this form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Hari, may always remain within you, in the core of your heart. If we simply keep Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu within our heart, then it will be very easy to understand what is Krishna. Because if you understand Krishna, then your life is successful. Janma karma chadibbam me jujanati tattva. That is only. Our Krishna consciousness movement means just try to understand Krishna. Then your life is successful. Krishna says, anyone who understands me, why I come here, what is my activity, takta dehang punarjana, he becomes liberated. After giving up this body, he does not accept any material body. In his own spiritual body, he goes back to home, back to God. This is our Krishna consciousness. So, if you don't go through Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it will be very difficult to understand Krishna. That is practical. Just like you young boys and girls from Western countries, you have taken up Krishna so seriously. Why? Because we are trying to understand Krishna through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So, we should follow this principle. There will be no difficulty to understand Krishna. And as soon as you understand Krishna, your life is successful. Of course, we cannot understand Krishna fully. As far as possible, at least if we understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, this much is sufficient. This much is sufficient. Krishna su Bhagavan Sayam. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Matta parataram nanyat kinchi jasti dhananjaya. Aham sarvasya prabhava. Aham adirhi dirmanam. These things are there, already stated. But the so-called scholars and politicians, they misinterpret in a different way and mislead the people. That is going on. Therefore, in spite of Bhagavad Gita being read all over the world for the last 200 years, not a single person became a devotee of Krishna. This is the defect. So, let us try to understand Krishna through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And as we have repeatedly said, that through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu you understand Krishna and spread this cult all over the world. People are suffering for want of knowledge of Krishna. So this movement especially meant to establish the cult of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The cult of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is that you become, every one of you, you become a guru. How to become guru? Na jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. Simply, that qualification is sufficient. Don't adulterate the Krishna upadesh. It's simply present what Krishna says as it is. Then every one of you will become a guru. Don't adulterate. I think, in my opinion, these nonsense things should be given up. We should always be aware that we are insignificant creature. Our opinion and thinking has no value. This should be the first principle. Why should you give opinion on the words of Krishna? Are you more authoritative person than Krishna? This is foolishness. To try to become more than Krishna. There are so many rascals, they present that now we have advanced, we know more than Krishna. So be saved from these rascals. Then you will understand Krishna, and through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu you will understand what is the position of Krishna, what is your relationship with Krishna, what is the ultimate goal of life. These things will be clearly exhibited. And Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita is written for this purpose, so that a person who is serious about Krishna consciousness may understand Krishna through the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This is one. You cannot jump over Krishna consciousness without going through the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And to go through Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu means to go through the six Goswamis. This is parampara system. Therefore, Narottamdas Thakur says, Eichhaya Gosai Jar Tarmi Das Tasavar Padorenu Mora Panchak Gras. This is parampara system. You cannot jump over. You must go through the parampara system. You have to approach through your spiritual master to the Goswamis, and through the Goswamis you will have to approach Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and through Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu you have to approach Krishna. This is the way. Therefore, Narottamdas Thakur says, Eichhaya Gosai Jar Tarami Das. We are servant of servant. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's instruction, Gopi Bhattu Padakamalayo Daso Daso Dasanu Daso. The more you become servant of the servant, the more you are perfect. And if you all of a sudden want to become master, then you go to hell. Don't do that. This is the teaching of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If you go through the servant, 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 then you are advanced. And if you think that you have now become master, then you are going to hell. This is the process. Dasa dasanu dasa. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says. So servant, 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 100 times servant now, that means he is advanced. He is advanced. And one who is becoming directly master, then he is in hell. Sanat-pita-charing-chira. So we should always remember the instruction of Srila Rupa Goswami. Therefore, we pray, Sri Chaitanya Manovistam Sthapitam Jina Bhutale. Our mission is to establish the desire of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That is our business. Sri Chaitanya Manovistam Sthapitam Jina Bhutale. Srila Rupa Goswami did it. He has given up so many books, especially Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, which you have translated into English as Nectar of Devotion, to understand the science of devotion and service. This is the greatest contribution of Srila Rupa Goswami, how to become a devotee. How to become a devotee? It is not sentiment. It is science. This Krishna consciousness movement is a great science.
Oh,
Krishna prema pradayate, Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya namine, Gauratise namaha. Sri Chaitanya manovishtam, sthapitam jena bhutale, sayang rupa kadamayam, dadati sapadantikam. He Krishna karunasindho, dinabandho jagatpate, Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaste. Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is addressed by Rupa Goswami as Mahavadana. Namo Mahabhadarnaya Krishna Prema Pradaya Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine Gauratise Namaha. So, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna Himself. Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namine. He has assumed the name of Krishna Chaitanya. Actually, he is Krishna. That is confirmed in many literature, especially in the Srimad Bhagavatam. It is said, Krishna Varnam Tisha Akrishnam Sangapangasta Parasadam Jagai Sankirtanai Prai Jajanti Hishunev. So, Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after taking his sannyas order, his name was Krishna Chaitanya. So Rupa Goswami said that you are Krishna. You have now come as Krishna Chaitanya. Why? Krishna Prema Pradaya. Just to distribute love of Krishna. And Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission was Prema Pumatha Maha.
Generally people understand dharma, artha, kama, moksha. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that above moksha, above liberation, there is love of God. That is what. Prema Pumartha Maha. And this is confirmed in the Srimad Bhagavatam that dharma projita koitabhatra parama nirmasaranam satam vastava vastu vedamam. And Siddhar Swami says that koitava dharma, in simple word, cheating. Koitava means cheating or false. So when there are false dealing, there is cheating. So according to Vyasadeva, dharma, artha, kama, moksha, that is not very essential thing. Real thing is how to advance in the science of loving God, Krishna, Krishna Prema. And the Srimad Bhagavatam says, Savai Pumsang Paru Dharmo Jatu Bhakti Radhukhaji Ahaituki Apratihata Jina Atma Sampratidati. If you want really peace, then you should stand on the platform of Parodharma. Parodharma, just like Krishna has described, Aparayam itastu vidhime prakitim para, para and para. Para is applicable to the purusha and para is applicable to the prakriti. So we are prakriti, we are not purusha. Purusha is Krishna, as described by Arjuna in the Bhagavad Gita. Parabrahma paramadhama pavitram paramam bhavam purusham shasvatam adyam. And in the Brahma Sangita also it is adi purusham. Krishna is described adi purusham, Ishara parama Krishna satchidananda vigraha anadi adi govindam tamaham bhajam. So this Krishna Bhakti, Krishna personally came to teach Krishna Bhakti. He came here in this district, Mathura, and Krishna birthplace is still there. So Krishna personally came to teach the science of Krishna Bhakti. And although he proposed that dharma sthapanartaya sambhavami yuge yuge, but at the end he says, sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam braj. And this is confirmed in the Srimad Bhagavatam that dharma projita koitabhata, except surrendering to the lotus feet of Krishna, anything which is going on in the name of dharma, that is not dharma. Therefore Krishna says, sarva dharman parityajya. When Krishna came, he did not come to re-establish Hindu religion or Christian religion or Muslim religion. No. Religion is religion. Gold is gold. You cannot say Hindu gold, Muslim gold, Christian gold. That is not possible. That is not possible. That is called koitava dharma, cheating dharma. Gold is gold, pure gold. Therefore, Bhagavad says, dharmantu sakshat bhagavat pranitam. Dharma means the order or the law given by
God. That is all. This is the simple explanation of it. If you want to know what do we mean by dharma, then dharma means dharmanta sakshad bhagavat praniya. Just like law. Law means which is given, sanctioned by the governor. You cannot make your law at home. You cannot say, the law given by the government or by the governor, I don't care for it. I shall make my own law. That is not possible. That will never be accepted as law. You can make your law. Similarly, if you manufacture dharma without any reference to the authority, that is not dharma. That is cheating religion. Dharma prajjita koitava. So therefore, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, what He is speaking, māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ, that is dharma. All other things are cheating. And when Krishna says, māmekaṁ saraṇaṁ braja, He does not say to any particular community or any country or any nation. He speaks to everyone. Sarva jouni sukanteya sambhavanti murtaya tasang mahajjani brahma ahanga bija pada pita. He says, I am the seed-giving father of all forms of life. Krishna does not say that I am speaking to Indian or the Hindus. No. Krishna speaking to everyone, to his every son. It doesn't matter whether he is white or black or blue, it doesn't matter. These are skin disease. Krishna says that we don't take this body as yours. Asmin dehe, dehin asmin jathadehi, kaumanajum. This transformation of the body, that is natural. But within the body, the part and parcel of Krishna is there. That we have to understand, that's the beginning of Bhagavad Gita. We have to understand what is there within the body. That is the beginning of spiritual education. Unfortunately, the whole world is going on under the impression that I am this body. I am Indian, I am European. That is condemned in the Shastra. Jashyatma buddhi kunapi tridhatu sadhik kalatra disubhoma ijjadhi jatitha buddhi salilena karihiti janesu avignesu saeva gokha. Go means cow and khara means ass. Jashyatma buddhi kunapi tridhatu. This bag of three dhatus, copper, pitta, vayu, if one takes it, that I am this body, I am Indian, I am American. So Shastra says, he is not even human being. Saiva gokha. So this Krishna consciousness movement is very, very important from this angle of vision, that everyone is thinking this body as he is. Nobody understands that he is within this body, just like we are within this is dress. I am not this dress. This is the primary education of spiritual life. Unfortunately, it is very much lacking. And now you can see practically that these European and American boys, they are all young men, but they have forgotten the bodily relationship. We have got in our institution Africans, Canadians, Australians, Europeans, Indians, but they do not consider with reference to this bodily concept of life. They live as eternal servant of Krishna. That is the instruction given by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Jiver sarup hoy nitya Krishna dar. So actually, if we want to be happy, then we have to accept the principle of Srimad Bhagavatam,
Jato bhakti radho khaje. Bhakti comes out of love. You cannot make one forced to love you. It comes automatically. That automatic love is there in everyone's heart for Krishna. That is stated in the Chaitanya Charitamrita. Nitya siddha Krishna bhakti saddha kabunay sravanadi suddha chitte karaya udaya. Udaya means it is awakened. Everyone has got love for Krishna within the heart. That is natural. But that love is distributed in different ways. How? Jashyatu buddhi kunapeti dhatake sadhik kalatradisu bhomai jadhik. This love has been distributed family-wise, community-wise, nation-wise, country-wise, like that. That this love has to be concentrated, converted to be love of Krishna. That is equal. Then everything is perfect. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching, and he practically Krishna Prema Pradhaya. To develop love for somebody, that requires very elaborate process. It is not, because we are in the darkness. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, manushyanam sahasyeshu kaschin jatati siddhai, jatatam api siddhanam kaschin vetimamta. So we cannot understand even Krishna. What is Krishna? Actually, there are so many malinterpretations about Krishna. I do not wish to discuss, because they have been made mistaken by big leaders. So people cannot understand even Krishna. What is Krishna? And what to speak of loving Krishna? That is very difficult. But Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he distributed this love of Krishna. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Lord Nityananda is standing before you, and he delivered many sinful persons to the transcendental position of love of Krishna. Srila Narottam Das Thakur has sung, Brajanda Nandana Jai Sachi Suto Hoilo Sei, Balaram Hoilo Nitai. This Balaram, he became Nitai, and Krishna, he became Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. These two brothers, the same two brothers, Ram Lakshan, Krishna Balaram, again, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda. So what was their business? The papi tapi jato chila hari name udhari. This is their business. All the papis and all the persons suffering from material anxieties, they delivered. Yes. How? Tarasakhi jagayar madhar. There are two brothers, Jagayan Madhai. They are very debauchers. The devotees means, what was their fault? The fault was that they took their birth in Brahmin family, but they became woman hunters and drunkards and cheaters like that. So Nityananda Prabhu delivered them to become first-class Vaishnava. Papi tapi jato chilo hari name udhari tara sakhi jagaya. So 500 years ago, to become a drunkard was most abominable, especially in the higher section of the Hindu society. But now it has become a fashion. So if you want to develop the position of the society, position of the country, which is now full with papi-tapi, you have to accept the process of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and that is practically being manifested. These European American boys, they are also
the same time, jagaya madhaya. That's a fact. They were at least. Now they are not. So how they have become delivered? The same process. Papita pijato chila harinami uddharila. So this Krishna consciousness movement is so important, and there is practical result that you introduce this chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra offenseless, not with offense. Then the world situation will improve very much. That's a fact. And it is being actually enacted in the present position. We are sending our men from village to village in Europe and America. We have introduced, we are taking advantage of the modern facilities. We are using this microphone for chanting Hare Krishna mantra. We are using nice buses, cars and wagons to go to village and distribute book and chant Hare Krishna. One of the leaders is present here, Sriman Tamal Krishna Goswami. He is controlling about 1 dozen buses. And here is Hansudut also. He is doing the same in Germany. So we have introduced this as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ordered. Prithivite ache jato nagaradija. Throughout the whole world, as many villages and towns are there, this Sankirtan movement should be introduced. And especially in India, because if in India the people are generally Krishna conscious, by artificial means they are trying to forget. This is the position. This should be stopped. They have got natural tendency for becoming Krishna conscious. Therefore, in these days, still so many hundreds and thousands of people coming to Vrindavan to relish the transcendental mellow of Krishna consciousness. And now the foreigners are also attracted to Krishna consciousness, and I am trying to place them in our temple. This temple is one of them. We have got 4 or 5 temples in India. We are constructing one big temple in Hyderabad, and we are getting good response. So it is our request to the leaders of the society and to the people of India that they may take this Krishna conscious movement, Hare Krishna movement, very seriously. It will be good for everyone, and the whole world will become peaceful. We do not expect that throughout the whole world everyone will take to Krishna consciousness. But even 5%, 2%, 3% people take to Krishna consciousness, there will be great example. Jajat acharati sreshtha lokastat anuvartate. So our only request is that this simple thing, Harir nama, Harir nama, Harir nama eva kevalam, kalo nasti eva nasti eva nasti eva gatirandatha, this formula of the Vedic Shastra. And you'll be surprised. I invite you to come to our different centers in Europe and America, how they are chanting, dancing before the deity Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Nityananda or Radha Krishna. Recently I had been to Atlanta for the first time, but the boys and the girls, that they have taken 3 big houses. The middle house has been transformed into temple. How nicely they're chanting and dancing. You'll be surprised if you go. So this movement is undoubtedly increasing in the foreign countries. Why not in our country? So the government, the leaders and the guardians, they should deeply contemplate on the serious nature of this movement and help us. Now we are bringing men from the foreign countries to preach. How long I shall bring?
If we want to spread this movement all over India very seriously, then we invite educated, intellectual, young men to come forward to study this movement. It is not blind, we have got books. We have already published about 50 books on this movement. So, for the Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement is meant for both kind of men. The ordinary man without any education, illiterate, he can also take to it, and the most advanced scientists, philosophers, philanthropists, politicians, they also can take to it. So, we are helping both ways. Those who are educated scientists, philosophers, for them we have got volumes of books. And those who are not educated, they can simply chant Hare Krishna. That will help them, both ways. Therefore, this movement has become important and interesting. Our books are being purchased by the topmost class of men, big professors in the universities. They are giving standing order. The books which are not published, they are putting standing order. Here our one sannyasi is present, Sasvarup. He is visiting the libraries, universities, professors, and we are getting very good response. So, don't take it as a sectarian movement. Don't misunderstand this movement as a CIA movement. These are our foolishness. Do you think that the Americans are so fools that for propagating their CIA movement they will become Vaishnava and chant and dance? The Americans have become so fools. No. They are taking it very seriously. They are not CIA, not American, nor European. They are Vaishnavas, they are servants of Krishna. Don't misunderstand them. And try to cooperate and help this movement for the benefit of the whole human society. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
লোকস্য অজানত বিদ্যান চক্রে সাতত সংহিতা সাতত মিন্স ইটারনাল অ্যান্ড সংহিতা মিন্স বৈদিক লিটারেচার বৈদিক লিটারেচার Veda means knowledge. There are two kinds of knowledge, material knowledge and spiritual knowledge. Material knowledge means regarding these necessities of this body. So, our educational system, the university, everything that is simply imparting material knowledge. But material knowledge is superfluous because this body is also superfluous. Every one of us we know that this body is non-permanent. It is temporary. We create a certain type of situation and we get a particular type of body and we enjoy or suffer. There is no question of enjoyment, it is suffering.
Just like we are running on this fan because the body is suffering. Otherwise, there is no necessity of this fan. And we require this light because without light, the eyes will suffer. So actually, our material knowledge, we have discovered this electricity just to counteract the sufferings of this material world. Kastana kaman. This body is therefore anartha. Anartha means things which are not required. That is called anartha. Artha means things which we require, positive. And anartha means things which we do not require, but unnecessarily imposed upon us. So that is suffering. We are thinking that we are enjoying this electric fan, but actually we are suffering. Therefore the electric fan is required. So why this electric fan is required? Because the body is anartha. It has created the situation. The same electric fan will be a trouble, a misery in winter season. The same body, the same electric fan, sometimes it is pleasing and sometimes it is not pleasing. Therefore, the conclusion is this body is anartha, not required. But people do not know that without this material body we can exist. Actually, you are existing in spiritual body, and this material body is a covering of the spiritual body. Just like your shirt and coat are covering of your real body, similarly, this material body is covering of the spiritual body. We have got our spiritual body. So, when a person comes to the understanding that this body is anartha, unnecessarily imposed upon me, that is called knowledge. That is called brahma-jnana, brahma-bhuta-prasanna. So, in order to educate people to this understanding, that is the basic principle of all Vedic knowledge, that I am not this body. I am spirit soul, and I must find out the ultimate goal of the spiritual body or the spirit soul. So, some of the transcendentalists, they think that if the spirit soul is merged into the supreme soul, that is called Brahma-lin, to become one with Brahma. That is the solution of this anartha. Anartha means this body. And some of them, they think that with our spiritual body, spiritual vision, if we can observe continuously the Supreme Spirit, Paramatma, then that is the solution of anartha. That is the yogi, jnani yogi, and the karmi, those who have no knowledge, ajanata, fools, rascals. Ajanata means one who does not know. That is the karmis. Karmis, they think that if I can satisfy the senses of this body, that is perfection of life. So, there are three kinds of philosophers to make the solution of this unwanted material body, anartha. But actual solution is to remain in your spiritual body and meet the Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face
and live with him in eternal blissful life of knowledge. That is Vaishnava philosophy. The Mayavadi philosophy or the Gyanis and Yogis and Karmis try to understand. The Karmis want to enjoy the senses of this body because the body is anartha. Therefore, sense gratification is another anartha. Because in this body, you are enjoying certain type or certain grade of material enjoyment, sense gratification, and if you want more than that, just like there are prescription menu of human food, vegetable, rice, wheat, sugar, this is actually the food for the human being. But if one hasn't got restriction within the area of the allotted foodstuff, because we have to accept allotted foodstuff. Everything is food, but the human being has got an allotted foodstuff by the Supreme Law. Ego jo bahunam vidadhati kama, that Supreme Personality of Godhead is supplying everyone foodstuff. But not that the dogs and hogs foodstuff is the same for the humankind. No. Tena taktena bhunjitha. You should enjoy as it is allotted by the Supreme Law. So, if we transgress this law, our constitutional position, anatomical fittings, is to eat fruit, vegetable, rice, wheat, milk or milk product. This is our constitutional position. But if we imitate the cats and dogs without any discrimination, if we eat, then my next body is ready, the hog's body or the dog's body. This is natural. Karanam gunasangasa sadasat janma jonis. As you associate with different types of material modes of nature, then you get the next body according. Therefore, on the whole, the body, either human body or demigod's body or cat's body or dog's body or tree's body or plant's body, it is unnecessary. Unnecessarily, we have accepted this material body. Because our position is not this body. Na hannate hannamane sarire. We are losing every time a particular type of body. But I am eternal. But people are so foolish, so rascal, they do not understand that if I am eternal, why I have to change my body? This is intelligence. So that intelligence is there. Here it is said, lokasya ajānata. The rascals, the fools, ajānata, foolish. Ajānata is another meaning of foolish. Ajānata, ajñānata, without any knowledge. How we can stop these perpetual, not perpetual, but at least for the time being, why you are subjected to this anartha? This is the inquiry. This is called brahma-jignasa. But they do not know it. Ask anybody of this material world, what is the cause of your suffering? They cannot explain, they do not know it. Therefore, it is particularly mentioned ajānata. They do not know how to mitigate this suffering. Therefore, vidvān, one who has got full knowledge, Vyāsadeva, he has made this sāttata saṅhita. Saṅhita means Vedic knowledge, and sāttata means pure, completely pure. Or for the Vaiṣṇavas, or this perfect spirituality. Lokasya ajanata vidyan chakri satata shani. How we can utilize this Srimad Bhagavatam, Sattata Samhita, that is also explained in the next verse. Jasyang vai siyamanaya krishne parama puruse bhakti rutpadyate vumsa sokamoha bhayapaha. Sokamoha bhaya, these things are our constant companion. Soka. Soka means lament. And moha means illusion, and bhaya, bhaya means fearfulness. So we are embarrassed with these things always. Soka, moha, and bhaya. Soka, we are always lamenting, this thing I am lost, I have lost this business, I have lost my son, I have lost so many. Because it is after all losing business. To exist in this material world means it is a losing business. There will be no profit. Therefore, whatever you are working for, searching after real happiness, if it is not devotional service, then the Bhagavad says, samayeva hi kevalam, simply working for nothing and the gain is labor. So people are suffering in this way, although they do not know, they are taking it as enjoying, that is illusion. Moha, that is called moha. So we are in the shoka, always in lamentation, but we are accepting the shoka position as enjoyable, shoka moha, and the result is that you are always fearful. Bhayam ditya avinivesatasya. This bhayam, that is the material nature, eating, sleeping, sex life, and bhayam, ahara nidra bhaya, maithunant. This is the bodily business. Eating, sleeping, sex life, and always fearful. What will happen next? What will happen next? These are the unorthodox. Actually, we are part and parcel of the Satchidananda Vigraha. Eternal, sat, full of knowledge, satchit and bliss, ananda, pleasure. This is our life. But this is not our life. Eating, sleeping, mating, these things are required only dityavi nivesatasyat. When we identify with the dhitiya, means the second. Second means I am not this body, but the body is the second feature. So when I identify myself with this body, that is called dhitiya vinivesh. And on account of our thoughts being absorbed in the secondary body, we are suffering. See, if we want to get relief from this suffering, then it is recommended jasyavayam siyamananam. If we regularly hear Srimad Bhagavatam, the Sattata Samhita, jasyavayam siyamananam. Siyamananam means simply hearing, sramanam. Then by hearing, what will be the effect? The effect will be Krishne Parama Puruse. Krishne Parama Puruse Bhakti Rutpadyate. The Supreme Person Krishna, and to him your devotional service will be increased. Because anartha prasannam sakshat bhakti yoga madakshat. The remedy has been described that if you be engaged in the devotional service of adhokhaja. Adhokhaja means the Supreme Person who is beyond your material experience. That is called adhokhaja. Akhaja means material. And adhokrita, when material knowledge fails, that is called adhokhaja. So if you be engaged in devotional service, upon this adhokhaje. And who is that adhokhaje? That is Krishna. Krishna you cannot understand by the material knowledge. They are studying Krishna with material knowledge. But it is not possible. That is said by Krishna himself in the Bhagavad Gita. Yoga-māyā samāvṛtaḥ nāhaṁ prakāsa sarvasya yoga-māyā samāvṛtaḥ. I am not exposed to everyone because yoga-māyā is covering their eyes. And another place Krishna says, abhajānanti māgamūḍhā manasim tanumāsya. Because I have come here to favor these people of this world, these rascals, mura means rascal, they are deriding, they are thinking Krishna as one of us. And therefore Krishna is adhokhaja. If you want to see Krishna by your material speculation, you will never be able to see Krishna. Yoga maya samabhi. But one may say that I can see Krishna by my pious activities. No, that also not possible. I can see Krishna by my philosophical speculation. No, that is also not possible. I can see Krishna by practicing yoga. Oh, that is also not possible. Then how it is possible? Krishna says, bhakta mām avijānāti. This particular process you have to accept. Bhakta. That is called bhakti yogam madhokaja. Everything is there symmetrically in every Vedic literature. We have to take advantage of it and benefit ourselves. So, the summary is that Krishna is beyond your material experimental knowledge. You cannot understand Krishna by these material senses. It is not possible. Then bhakti yoga. Bhakti yoga. Bhakti means to engage oneself in the service. The more you engage in the service of the Lord, the more you realize what is Krishna. Otherwise it is not possible. If you don't accept bhakti yoga, if you accept jnana yoga, karma yoga, or hatha yoga, then you can make some material progress, but there is no possibility of understanding Krishna. Therefore, it is recommended here, the bhakti yoga, particularly, everywhere it is made. Bhakti, bhaktya mām avijānāti, javānjaschāmi tattvata. So, the Śrīmad Bhāgavatam is further explanation of the knowledge given in the Bhagavad Gita. So it is recommended also that we have to hear Śrīmad Bhāgavatam always, 24 hours, not that Bhāgavat Saptaha, it is a business. Bhāgavat Saptaha is not recommended in anywhere in authorized scripture. There are many big commentators of Śrīmad Bhāgavatam. Siddhar Swami, B. Raghavacharya, Vishwanath Chakravarti, Jiva Goswami and many others. They are eight authorized. Nowhere you will find Bhagavat Saptaha is recommended. No. Bhagavat should be studied every day. Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. That is recommended. Nashta Prayeshu Abhadreshu. Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Nityam means always, at least daily. So these temples are meant for hearing Śrīmad Bhāgavatam daily. That is it. Not that I make a ceremony, I hear for one week without understanding a word of Bhāgavat. I hear for one week and the business is finished. No. You have to hear Śrīmad Bhāgavatam daily, regularly, then anartha upasamam sāpsa. This sattata saṅgita is given by Śrīla Vyāsadeva so that we are fools, rascal, ajanata, ajanata, lokasya ajanata. All these fools and rascals, if they hear with great attention from Srimad Bhagavatam about the activities and glories of Krishna, the Shravan Siyamana, Krishna Paramapurusha, he is the Paramapurusha. That is the verdict of all Vedic literature. Ishara Parama Krishna. He is Ishara Paramapurusha, the Supreme Person. Ishara means the Supreme Person. in the English dictionary also, it is said, God means the Supreme Person. God means the Supreme Person. So that Supreme Person is Krishna. And Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Matta Paratanam Nanna. There is no more superior authority than me. But people do not understand because ajānata. Ajānata means without any knowledge. So you have to take knowledge from Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam about Krishna. Krishna Parama Purusha Bhakti Vipadate.
Now illustrated weekly is nothing compared to
that. No. Better than yesterday. I thought of getting some help from artist for painting. Picture I will dictate and they will paint picture. Now Krishna has got lots of artists. So depend on Krishna. He can do everything. Because he is Arjuna, devotee, he simply understood. Yes, whatever he says, correct. The demons, even the gods, they cannot understand. Oh, why Arjuna understood? That he has explained in the 13th chapter. Nashto moho sati labhya tat prasadat madhusudana.
Is he never envious?
Huh?
I just said, my dear Krishna, O infallible one, my illusion is now gone. I have regained my memory by your mercy, and I am now firm and free from doubt and prepared to act according to your instructions.
Yes. He understood that Krishna is divine. So whatever he says, that is my duty to do. Not to judge him on my platform. And that is Krishna's mercy. One who does not take Krishna in the same platform as one he is, but accepts Krishna's version as it is, then he can understand. Otherwise, how one can accept it that a person has expanded many millions of universes like this? Immediately they will take his mythology. Because he is thinking on terms of his capacity, not as Krishna says. Therefore, nobody could understand Krishna. We took the simple method. Accept Krishna as he says. That's all. There is an idea. Our philosophy is simple because we take it, Krishna's words as it is. That's all. And we believe it firmly. Yes, this is the truth. To understand Krishna is not difficult. What Krishna says, we accept it. Sarvamayitam ritam manne jat badashi kesara. Whatever you say, I accept. Not only I accept it blindly, but this very thing was accepted by such great personality as Vyasa, anyone who wants to come. Simple thing. Big acharya. They accepted Krishna as he is. Now why shall I not accept? This is parampara system. If others have accepted Krishna as he tells, and they have become big acharyas, what objection can be there from my part? What I am?
They have some completely illogical argument, just like those people in...
Unfortunate. Illogical argument means unfortunate. Rascals. Therefore we say plainly, you are all rascals. We have no discrimination. Anyone who does not believe as he is a rascal. You may be happy or sorry, you don't mind. You don't make compromise. At least I do not do. If you have no full faith in Krishna, then you are rascal. Whatever you do. The Dr. Patel does not like this, but he does not protest to me. As others say, he protests by me. This is fine. We have no difficulty to understand Krishna and thus make our life successful. But we unnecessarily glean arguments, impediments to understand Krishna. Therefore we are unfortunate. Envious.
They say that they become very agitated when we stress so much in Bhagavad Gita.
That means envy. Envious.
They said, why is it so...
Tanahanga disata krura. Find out. Tanahanga disata krura.
Those who are envious and mischievous, who are the lowest among men, are cast by me into the ocean of material existence into various demonic species of life.
All of them are going to Russia. Not Russian people are there. There is a mistake. Some of them. Russian people are good.
Leaders.
That I have experienced. Otherwise, how? Otherwise, how that Anatole came to become mine? And there are many like that, mostly like him. It is by artificial suppression that it has been advertised that Russian people are all communists. That's not fair. Simply some rogues and thieves and demons by threat. It is a country of what is called terrorism.
Yeah.
A terror. People have decided to leave this country, but they cannot leave. Mostly Russians, they want to leave the country, and some of them already done so. Many Russians have fled us. Many Chinese men have fled us. They don't like this place.
Also, the East Europe countries.
Many countries. It is unnatural to deny God. It is unnatural. This is also Krishna's another magic. All such people who had any doubt about Krishna, they have been kept together in that way. Just like the other day, there was a train crash. accident. So all these rascals, they are brought together in that way, in a train, or two train and this mast. That is just like Krishna did in battle of Kurukshetra. All the rascals, they are brought into the battlefield and finished.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama.
This is the duty of our disciples under the guidance of the spiritual master to decorate Sivigrahara Dhananitanana Singara. Singara means decoration. Among the various paraphernalia of worshipping the Lord, the Singara is very essential. Singara and Tan Mandira Mahadhanadi and cleansing the temple. The more you cleanse the temple, the more you decorate the deity, more your heart becomes cleansed and you become spiritually decorated. So cleanliness is next to godliness, and after cleansing, taking baths regularly, keeping the temple very neat and clean, and worshipping the deity, dressing, decorating, ornamenting, these are the general process. So if we follow the process regularly, then we gradually become advanced in spiritual consciousness. Material world and spiritual world. Material world means dirty things, and spiritual world means clean. So the living entities, they are called tatasya-shakti. Parasya-shakti vividhaiva sriyate. God has many potencies. They have been divided into three.
You wanted the European American should come here. It is all Bhaktivinoda Thakur's blessing. Hare Krishna. So there is no scarcity of space for keeping all the devotees.
Everyone is situated in rooms.
Without these wall dwellings, there would have been no hope.
Therefore I said, we must complete, and whatever amount required, I shall pay. That I could not know.
You should have Prabhupada. Only by your mercy you have brought us to this Krishna conscious movement.
I am simply a messenger. Mercy is our doctrine of Thakur, Srila Prabhupada. Before your coming, they predicted that somebody will bring. Maybe that somebody has. But Krishna Thakur predicted. So anyway, Krishna has given us nice place, stay here. So you producing food grains?
Oh yes.
Sufficient? What about the fruit garden?
Fruit garden, there's many banana trees are producing the bananas, some pomegranates.
You are getting banana. Both unripe and ripe.
Well, now they're all unripe.
No, there is a class.
Right, the kachakola we have getting very small. We have mostly the ripening.
And we sincerely engaged in the service of the Lord. He gives him intelligence, now do this, do this. Simply we have to become sincere servant, then all dictation will come from within. Krishna is there in everyone's heart. So, work sincerely, and everything will make problem. Who has painted this picture?
Krishna.
Oh. Very nice. Now, make sublime management. That is required now. We are now extended. We must manage very nicely. Of course, management means sincere service, and everything is all right. Still, we have to deal with the material world. We have to become a little cautious.
Everything you plan is perfect.
No, I imagine Krishna makes it perfect. I think it would have been nice if it would have been like this. But Krishna, Je prasade pure sarvas. Long, long ago when I was publishing Back to God at one seat, I was thinking that what if this seat, if it would have been like illustrated weekly, then it would have been nice. Now they are coming like that.